Hello everyone, my name is Mitz, and here we're back with Phoenix Wright Contempt Court. We basically got a resume in the roast about apparently the gun that was used that everyone thinks was the main weapon of the crime. What was it? This is not producing the same exact sound, as this is supposed to be a sharp, quick sharp sound. It's a gun that the butler heard. Don't know if it applies to us as well. With a large booming noise, and you can only imagine that all goes to this other gun, which we'll present now. I can only imagine we're gonna present it now.
I object!
Ruled. Please continue, Mr. Wright.
Yes, Mr. Wright, please do continue. There were no other firearms found around the hotel or on the guests.
That's where you're wrong, Bucko.
Where does the imaginary other gun come from?
I wonder what this is. I don't know, Brisby. Can you tell me? I've been blind so far. Can you tell me who? Seen this before, Brisbane?
Isn't the shield on the wall of the hotel's lobby? Wait. You're not. You're honestly not.
Don't worry about it. I might be. That's suggesting that one of the pistols on this shield might have been the real murder weapon. Matter of like how that gun comes into play, because thinking about it, really, it's either soon because of how the bellboy puts it, he was at the elevator the whole time, and I'm pretty sure you would notice if someone else walked into the hallway to the doorway that's in his room and all that. So, this is obviously a case of the killer was in the victim's room from the beginning, then when Maris came in, they killed him. Then, they hit him on the scene. That sort of thing, right?
Mr. Wright, what are these items doing in a hotel?
Decoration, Your Honor. They're decorations, Your Honor. Oh, wow, okay, never mind. Antique flintlock pistols, which, to my knowledge, produce a very loud sound.
Objection! Say that part again.
They were antique flintlock pistols.
Not that part. Something about the pistols being decorations.
Oh, you're going with that angle.
They must have been decommissioned for display purposes.
Do you know that for a fact, Brisbane? Are you just assuming things?
Why don't you ask the witness about them then?
Well, I'm not so sure myself, sir.
Maybe these pistols are worth looking into. Bailiff, please contact the police department about an examination of the lobby's pistols.
Before you even think about such a thing, I will Mr. Wong tell us why he thinks these pistols are even worth investigating.
Gun. That's why.
How do you mean, Mr. Brisbane?
I went to the fence to prove that these pistols were even touched that night.
The last thing I noticed about those pistols yesterday, I just didn't remember what it was. Very well. The wall shield was disturbed that night. I can prove this because pistols missing, the both pistols were missing, the dust was disturbed. I'm assuming we can't even prove the whole fact, we saw the pistol missing. So, but the dust will disturb, Oh, okay, I see now. This is the very leftmost gun. It's very dull, and the right one is the looks newer. So yeah, the dust has been messed with. Yeah.
Go with that.
The dust was disturbed. Have a close look at the shield once more. I couldn't put my finger on it before, but now I know what's wrong. The shield was covered in dust, but now, if you look at the pistol on top, there's no dust in it at all.
Does appear less faded than the other. Why, you're absolutely right. There's no dust in this pistol.
Dang, this pistol must be dust allergic. Someone discharged the gun just to get rid of the dust and just put it back. That's the only reason.
Bailiff, order an examination of this pistol post-haste.
Hold it.
Who was that just now?
That would have been me, Your Honor. Mr. Wright, I hope I haven't caused you any inconvenience. But I couldn't see that pistol anywhere in the victim's room that night, sir.
Huh? It wasn't the scene?
Christmas, right. Well, I guess if we're going with that, then, the killer just had it on them the whole time.
Wait, hold on a minute. What do you mean you couldn't find it?
I... I was the first person to stumble upon the scene, sir. What? Why didn't you tell us this before, witness? It must have slipped my mind, Your Honor. I apologize profoundly.
You can apologize by testifying as to what you found.
The bellboy was the one to see the scene before the other guests. What did he see? Will it change anything? Top of my head. It's, like, even Richmond said he hasn't seen, like, there was nothing too, like, there was nothing different about every single person's, you know, statements with each other, so this is gonna be interesting. The door was ajar. I entered literally seconds as I heard the noise. She just stood there. The victim's lying dead with a revolver on the floor. She was muttering the word ghost, but she was the only person in the room.
Ghost, you say? Are you sure you heard her correctly, witness?
I'm fairly certain that's what she was saying, sir.
Oh, come on, Judge, you can't seriously believe this.
Shut your pie hole, you. Do you even like pie? Well, then shut your food mouth.
Maybe the defendant was mistaken. May I begin the cross-examination, Mr. Wright?
I'm sorry, Mr. Rubin. This definitely seems like what happened. Like, everyone, like, we wanted to see, like, she was muttering with the ghost as well. Door was ajar. Lily entered Lily seconds and heard the noise. So Lily, after the gunshot, the gun was already on the ground, at least that one. That's the thing, so that pistol the victim was carrying was disturbed at some point. So, like, what was going on with that gun? How many seconds? I'm not in the habit of remembering exact measurements of time, sir, but I was looking at my watch and it was 2.5 microseconds at the gunshot. I was really fast at the door, sir. Basically, I headed for the victim's room as soon as I heard the noise.
And you're about to use the elevator, correct?
That's correct.
I see. So when you entered, what was Miss Rubin doing?
Can you describe in more detail exactly what you saw, witness?
Exactly, you say. Well, Miss Rubin was sitting not too far away from the door. She was frozen in shock, and she was stammering incoherently to herself. I don't think she ever heard me come in, sir. What I did was run to the body lying face up in the middle of the room. I saw the gun. It was about 10 feet away from the body, sir. Near the bed.
Oh, this doesn't help me at all. Thought you'd stumble onto something to help your case? Yes. I don't want this to be an open shut case, I want it to be wide open.
Start producing evidence and the source examination is over.
Oh boy. She was muttering the word ghost, but she was the only person in the room. Don't even think we have anything for, like, evidence-wise yet. You don't know that for a fact.
I'm afraid I'd have to disagree with you, sir. There are no other exits from the guest rooms apart from the doors. And the windows don't open wide enough for somebody to squeeze through.
Correct, and the investigation turned up these same facts, too. Start grasping and start producing evidence, wrong!
Unless you're trying to prove that this ghost actually existed.
She couldn't have been seeing things. Maybe she did see my first being in the room? But how do I prove something like that? It has to be a reason Maris saw someone.
Oh. I believe we examined the witness' testimony enough by now, Mr. Wright?
Okay.
Have you found any contradictions or not?
I can't. I can't even think, let alone prove what Maris saw is true. I need more time to investigate.
So if we need more time to investigate, that means we gotta pin on someone and just investigate more to, you know, and justify as the means. Game one, case three.
Yeah, excuse me.
Wendy Obag, best framer. Frame her.
No, Your Honor. The defense has nothing to say. Why are you speaking right now?
My, are you admitting defeat, Mr. Wrong?
Well, I mean, I'm always right, but right now, I'm, yeah.
Far from it, Brisbane. Your Honor, I'd like more time to investigate.
More time? But the crime scene has been thoroughly investigated enough already. What would you possibly gain from examining it again?
That's a point. Oh, boy. Looking at the crime scene again wouldn't bring about any new results. So what or where should I cross-examine? Well, this thing caught my head a couple minutes ago. Since I like to... Wait. Your Honor, I believe there's part of the hotel that's been overlooked. Yeah, okay, that's what was on my mind. What was it? I was thinking about, like, Lily, since he was the first, like, the bellboy was the first person to enter the room. I was thinking along the lines of, like, he was in the hallway the entire time, so he would have saw someone, like, going and entering. I mean, like, because, since of how... So, if we are what we were saying about Phoenix entering the hotel for the first time and talking to Maris is true, that means all the guests are on the second floor of the hotel. Every single guest, and the first floor is completely vacant for renovations.
Objection.
Nothing has been overlooked. Snow was under my careful watch yesterday.
Wait, you were in the room the whole time?
Not that careful, seeing as you lucked into the crime scene on his own. May I continue?
Psh, go ahead, you're wasting your time, though.
Tell Smarty, which part of the hotel should we be investigated?
Obviously, the second floor. The second first floor in European time. The first floor.
Why the floor in particular?
The night before the murder, as I was checking into the hotel, Miss Rubin told me something. Promise me you won't go to the first floor? We should probably break the promise in this investigation. It's just that with the renovations going on, it's quite dangerous up there. Dang, you'll see a lot of hammers and nails. I don't want you to, you know, use those. Oh, no problem. I probably want to go to the first floor anyway. Did you and Snow check out the first floor at all?
I don't believe we did, no.
You didn't? Why ever not?
Two reasons. One, you're the defense, there were apparently renovations going on. And two, we didn't find that relevant. The crime happened on the second floor, after all.
I see.
I agree with the defense. I believe a full investigation of the hotel is required. Therefore, I grant the police permission to investigate the first floor.
I have to agree with Brisbane, though. How can the first floor be relevant?
We get to see if there's any weird goings on with the construction. Maybe if we investigate the room underneath the crime scene, we reveal how shoddy the construction is, and the whole place with the collapsing down. Maybe the whole room was busted down with Maris inside, and like the victim just stumbled and just landed on a big old giant nail. Yeah. And then the construction guys immediately build it all up again, the room! Ah, perfect crime.
That's the only untouched part of the hotel. There has to be something. Well, I mean, is it untouched as the dust was disturbed by guns?
No.
Thank you for testimonies, bellboy. You may sit down from the stand now.
The pleasure was all mine, your honor. Anything I can do for justice.
I grant permission for one more day of investigation. Then the first floor of the Maple Fork Hotel. However, if no new information or evidence is found before court reconvenes tomorrow, the court will regard the bellboy's testimonies as reliable and Miss Rubin be found guilty.
One more day of investigation. Find something, or this will all have been for nothing.
And secretly, we go through the whole second investigation day. There's absolutely nothing. And okay, I am not still sleeping, phone.
We just find absolutely nothing in the first floor. There's absolutely nothing, and just go like, okay, what do we do now? Oh God.
Very well. The trial will continue tomorrow morning. Court is adjourned.
12:47 p.m. I love my 47 p.m.s.
So what happens now, Mr. Wright?
We need to examine the first floor, whatever that uncovers. Assuming it's going to be like the exact same as the second floor. Probably has more construction. Lots of boards and hammers and nails and oh, so many nails.
The police are allowed one more day of investigation. I promise I'll do all I can to help you.
I was telling the truth.
Huh? About what?
About the ghost.
I swear my life I saw him. You had to believe me.
What's this belief of the ghost I'm concerned about?
Tiredness.
It's proving the ghost was present.
Huh? Miss Rubin?
Are you alright? Would you like to...
Ah!
Miss Rubin, what's wrong?
I remember... something.
She's trembling like crazy.
What's the matter? What did you remember?
I remember shooting someone.
Okay.
So this is definitely is the Nickel Samurai case all over again. Oh, we can't trust you anymore. I'm gonna immediately quit my job here.
She passed out. She finally remembered the key moment of the night. I remember shooting someone. I don't believe it. She shot Mr. Nymph after all?
I guess, like, if she was the one holding that gun and she shot it, that explains why that gun was on the ground. But,
I remember shooting someone. At least you know now that she did touch the gun. She picked it up and even fired it. But was it really the victim she shot? There was somebody else in that room. And also thinking about it, the bullet in the room has been, it just went missing, so,
I wonder if she's alright. That probably wasn't a pleasant memory to remember. Maybe I should go see her.
Oh, okay.
Hey, forget about the first floor. Let's go do a therapist talk with her.
Funny. Could have sworn I just heard a door open.
Somebody's coming out of the victim's room.
Oh.
It's Terry Greason. Dang, the detective is going up in the police detective world of fake business.
Oh, he saw us. He snuck up on the corner towards the stairs. What was he doing in the victim's room? Huh. Before we go chase after him, I'm actually curious. April 3rd, Maplethorpe Hotel, room 206.
What was Grayson doing in here? How did he get in, for that matter?
Huh. That thing seems to be out of the ordinary. It looks like he just investigated, like, everything. I mean, like, oh yeah, the coat stand. Like, I was actually thinking, like, that proves there's a ghost there, but yeah, the whole struggle thing? Well, there's that contradiction. Mysterious knocked over coat stand. How did it happen? And since the victim's body's, like, you know, face up, that, you know, Yeah. If Maris really was, like, holding a gun, like, the victim was facing her, and she shot, he would go backwards, yeah. Oh boy, that lines up a lot. Tape forms the outline of his body. Well, that would mean, like, well, somehow, wait, straight on. That would mean the bullet trajectory would go horizontally. So, like, Smear is outline different somehow. Looks like part of the tape has been moved.
Moved?
Better take a look. Oh. The tape near the victim's foot has been moved. But what's that? A hole in the floor? What's this doing here? It's so dark, I can probably see into the room below. Did Greason make this hole? Or was this here the whole time? Oh. What does this mean? That really raises a lot of different possibilities. I think the first floor definitely is now more relevant. I wonder why. Let's see if we can go down there first off. No, we can't.
We're being railroaded to talk to Maris and be therapists. Dang, I want to see the first floor. I want to see and get myself hurt on some construction nails, please.
Oh, both the guns are gone. That's strange. The front door's stuck. Ow, that didn't do it either. Oh my god, we're trying to bust it down.
You're such a head of experience with busting down doors, but jeez.
Now I'm gonna get out of here. Excuse me, sir. Oh, hi. The front door's jammed, I'm afraid.
Oh, hi, Cedric.
You'll take the back door in the lounge and leave through the garden. Oh, right. Thank you, Mr. Maplethorpe, was it? Remember Maris saying, like, you know, Cedric, when, you know, discovery of the body thing. Remember from the night of the murder?
Yes, I am.
And you're Phoenix Wright, aren't you? Let me tell you something. Maris is innocent.
Oh, dang.
Take it from me, Mr. Wright. She wouldn't harm a fly. If she had a fly sweater, I mean, I guess. I'm sure she wouldn't. Don't worry, I'll sort this whole mess out. Classical. Is that a harpsichord? So, nice place you have here. Did you build it yourself? Do you come here often?
It's not as nice as it once was, I must admit.
I'm getting Snow's voice now. And the place myself was much more preferable. I don't even remember if I gave this guy a good clear voice. Then why did you decide to turn into a hotel? Living this far away from civilization doesn't promise a favorable income. I begin to run short of money to pay for the renovation of the house. You know, the house is 200 years old and suffice to say, starting to fall apart. Turning into a hotel was the only way I could obtain enough money. See, Maris was right. He is misanthropic. And I thought by employing my dear friend Maris the maid, a diva hotel could flourish. Indeed, it has. The only downside is that the first floor is always under construction. It's never once been in operation. Never once? Result, we can't have too many guests at one time. I've taken me all this way to find out there are no vacancies. And didn't Mary say the renovation began just 3 days ago? You send apology letters as soon as possible, of course. Have you known Maris for long? Not too long. 3 or 4 years, maybe. Did you mention she was a family friend? Yeah, sort of. She was engaged to my late brother, James. Maris is engaged? I wasn't expecting that. Hold on, Matt. Did you say late brother? Yes, he... was involved in a fortune accident. Oh, I'm sorry. I had no idea. But don't worry about it. That was over 3 years ago now. But still, you're the last surviving maple... Oops. Oh, Maris told you about that, didn't she?
I heard that, you know, you're the last surviving family branch of your tree. How does it feel? Does it feel good? I hope it does. You're the last surviving member. So if you don't reproduce and repopulate, then your family line's dead.
Is it true? I'm afraid so.
There's been an extreme misfortune associated with the Maplethorpe bloodline. Some believed it to be a curse.
A curse?
I'm sure you heard that story about the ghost of this hotel, yes?
Yeah? What about it?
I don't like talking about it, to be honest, but I will mention one thing. The ghost is believed to be responsible for the Maplethorpe curse. We need to learn this ghost story at some point, huh?
The hotel seems to have an interesting history from what I can see.
Yes, interesting.
Is there anything else that you can tell me about the ghost?
I can imagine it's like there was a call for another the victim's room at the same time. They employed the whole thing about the ghost story. You know, just pretending to be there, and had, like, Maris misinterpreted as, you know, ghost.
Ghost.
The ghost? What would you possibly find interesting about the ghost?
But it's a ghost! It's the otherworldly being! How would I not be interested?
Well, is there a story behind it?
Okay, we touched a nerve.
What did I say?
There's
not much of interest to tell, Mr. Wright.
Okay. Okay, so then, sorry. That was a strange reaction.
I think I touched a nerve by mentioning the ghost.
Oh, look at the time! I have to be going now. Sorry for bringing it past trauma. Tell me when you see the ghost. Like, you mean you're less of a Mapplethorpe after all. Tell me when you get a girlfriend. I've been saying that. I'm a dick.
Thank you for your time, Mr. Mapplethorpe. It was my pleasure. Just remember to use the back door in the lounge if you want to leave. I'll see you to warn the others who try to use the front door.
Will do. Thanks. Oh, and Mr. Mapplethorpe? Did you know that today the police are obliged to investigate the first floor?
Yes, I know. They're up there now. They're lucky the renovations are in progress today. Oh, and they gave me strict instructions.
Oh boy.
They told me to let a spiky-haired lawyer up there until they were finished. Thanks for making my life a little bit harder, Brisbane.
The first floor. We're not gonna move. Okay, so that explains that. We're not gonna investigate just now, but probably later today.
That I never get to investigate at all.
It'd be a good idea to investigate it myself later.
Guess we just have to move around all the way to the lounge.
And to the garden. Oh, this is the back of the hotel. Ooh. Yeah, this is definitely a three-story house.
Yeah, house. House hotel. Motel.
This is the garden. Now, I need to walk around this hotel to the front, so... Huh? There's someone else here. Oh, hi. Who's that guy? He seems to be trying to look into one of the windows. Dang, you're peeping Tom already. He spotted me.
Hey, you! Stay where you are!
Huh? What for?
Keep still for a moment.
What's that thing?
Shush! Ugh, nothing again. Never mind, you can go now.
Would you mind telling me what's going on here?
Eh? What's going on with that? I'm just trying to do a job here.
What job is that? What's that on your goddamn back?
Ah, fine, fine. How's the way you get the intros over and done with then? The name's Victor Barrows. Ghost Hunter Extraordinaire.
Is that thing in your back a vacuum cleaner?
Ghost Hunter? My friends call me Vic.
Vic Vapor. So, Mr. Barrows, I'm Phoenix Wright, attorney at law.
Trying to upstage me with a fancy profession? It ain't working, chief.
Okay.
Wow, I don't like you already.
Okay, then. So how's the wife and kids? Oh, wait, you don't have kids, or and your wife died a couple days ago? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Did you get a girlfriend yet?
Did you say you were a ghost hunter?
Sure did. What of it?
Is that why you're here? To hunt a ghost at the Maplethorpe Hotel?
Nothing gets by you, does it? This ain't just a hobby, it's a profession. And darn proud of it I am, too. Oh my god, are you a reality TV show kind of person?
Specters, phantom spirits, phantasmagorical entities, you name it.
And where does the ghost of this place is sure worth looking into.
Is that what the gadget of yours is for?
What, this?
Yeah, this place is a junk source that detects spiritual energy.
Huh.
The damn thing is yet.
Either that or nobody you've scanned with your modified calculator is a ghost.
I'm no ghost expert like yourself, but isn't the best time to search for ghosts at night?
What, are you saying that ghosts only like the nighttime? Ghosts like the daytime too, they don't want to bask and tan the sun, you know? That's ghostist.
I know that, genius. You're telling me how to do my job?
Oh, I wouldn't dream of it. Can you give me some tips on my lawyer job while we're at it?
And scouting, you must know. I'm looking for areas that ghosts might have been sighted.
I mentioned the first floor, but I'm not helping this guy. Besides, is he even aware that a murder has happened?
Are you guest here?
Of course, I'm staying in 201.
This is my neighbor across the hall.
Great. Late into the night, that's what kept us up all night. Just hearing the constant room of a vacuum cleaner.
Goddamn ghost on my goddamn room.
Light all these candles and just do spiritual energy stuff.
Out of this house. Out of this house.
Hired to find the ghost I was.
Hired? Who hired you?
Trade secret, chief. I ain't telling you squat.
This is not that important anyway.
Guess not.
Did you injure yourself searching for the ghost?
Yeah, that bandage in your nose.
Huh? What's that? You trying to be funny? You trying to be clever?
Put away the vacuum cleaner. No one has to get hurt.
No, just the plaster in your nose.
Plaster?
That word sounds vaguely familiar. Wait one second, let me go on a dictionary spree one second. Never mind the fact, dictionary. Let's see, plaster. That just sounds like another word for a bandage, but I feel like there's something else going on.
The first thing that comes up is a building material used for protective or decorative coating of walls.
Are you secretly a house in a person disguise?
let's see. Definition. Okay, British. It's an adhesive strip of material for covering cuts and wounds. Okay.
This game is so European.
Oh, that. How did I get it? I can't remember.
Oh.
Smart like hell, though, so I'm guessing it was recent.
Smart. Yeah, okay, yeah, definitely.
Let's fall off bed or something. Dang, you must have rolled on the wrong side of the bed. Wait.
The bed's against the wall unless your room is so different. Did you have the exact same room as the victim? Just a floor poster bed? God damn it, does everyone have a better room than me? Oh.
Anyways, enough about me. What are you doing out here? I'm trying to work.
Don't get me from your vacuum cleaning job. Like, have fun cleaning the place. Don't let me interrupt your progress. I'm just passing through.
Passing through, huh? Well, keep moving then.
Keep moving.
I'll probably catch you later when I'm done here.
Unfortunately. Oh boy. Wait, I remember something about this. Oh my god. Okay, before, like, I assume we're just gonna end things off here. Oh boy. I wanna, like, see this. Yes.
Mr. Bros, would you stop right there? Keep that thing still.
I remember this part.
I found something. What you got there, Chief?
What, this? It's my Magatama.
I got my scanner. It's charged with a strong spiritual energy.
No way. That piece of junk actually works?
You gotta let me take a look at it. I know these things. I need to see it.
Sorry, but it's just an ordinary piece of rock. The scanner must be broken.
The scanner never lies, Chief. That rock is a vessel of powerful spiritual essence.
No, seriously, it's just a rock. It's just my lucky rock, that's all. This is my lucky shirt. Oh, God.
Fine, keep it. Keep your secrets. You'll only be missing out on all the money we can make from that thing. The supernatural find of the year, the decade, the century.
Oh, God. Just slowly back away, Phoenix. Very slowly. Oh, boy. Like, I think it's on my head. Like, that's the one I remember the most. Like, just some, presenting anything goes to the whole thing of, like, yeah. Yeah, scanning it. And most of the time, it's just all, yeah. It's all negative. There's not any poltergeist activity associated with the object. It's not shifted either. That can only mean... That's junk! Take it away!
But this is my mother's special key. Never mind the fact I got this from the hotel.
Fine, I'll come back when I find a poltergeist or shapeshifter, or whatever the hell. Animorphs. That's a good book series. I haven't even got to the end. I read a couple books in the beginning, just stop for some reason or another. Oh well. Well, at some point we need to talk to Maris. I'm assuming we're gonna do that next time. And to be honest, it's, like, I can't even really imagine what we're gonna do this whole time, except for, like, maybe talk to this guy later on again. Like, he seems to be. This guy has to be important for a reason, right? Oh, this is probably where we probably hear about the ghost story later on. Yeah, makes sense. We hear about the ghost story from him later on, and then, for that story with what's on the crime scene, we can see what the killer was trying to do, what's going up to. That hole in the ground, the first floor of the hotel. Huh. There's many different factors here at play. Well, we got a few points of interesting leads, which we'll get to next time. So, for a fun time watching as I am playing this, we see you next time, what time may be, and I all hope a fantastic day.